Welcome back to our PFAS Basics series. One of the most common ways people are exposed to PFAS is through contaminated drinking water. It can be upsetting to learn that you've been exposed to any toxic chemical, including PFAS. Educating yourself about PFAS and ways you can reduce your exposure can help you manage concerns and stress levels. This video covers steps you can take to reduce your exposure if you have PFAS in your water you drink and cook with every day. The science around PFAS and ways to lower your exposure is changing quickly. This video reflects what we know as of February 2023 and will be updated as we learn more. Millions of Americans have PFAS in their drinking water supplies. While the federal government has not set safety standards for PFAS in drinking water, Washington State adopted our own rules to inform communities about PFAS in drinking water when it is found. Washington has state action levels, or SALs, for PFAS in drinking water. The SALs help you know when you should act to lower PFAS levels in the water you drink and cook with regularly, such as every day, to protect your health. Right now, Washington has SALs for 5 PFAS chemicals: perfluorooctane sulfonic acid, or PFOS, PFOS; perfluorooctanoic acid, or PFOA, PFOA; perfluoronanoic acid, or PFNA; perfluorohexane sulfonic acid, or PFHXS; and perfluorobutane sulfonic acid, PFBS. Because PFAS don't have a taste or smell and don't change the color of your water, getting a water test that can detect PFAS is the only way you can be sure if the chemicals are in your water. The SALs require over 2,400 public water systems in Washington to test for PFAS. If you receive a water bill every month or have a water meter on the side of the building you live in, you probably get your water from a public water system. Your public water system will contact you if you have PFAS in your drinking water above one of the SALs. Most public water systems have to test for PFAS by 2025. If PFAS are found at levels near or above the SALs by your public water system, they will do follow-up testing and notify customers. All PFAS test results are also sent to Washington State Department of Health. Contact your public water system to find out if your water has been tested for PFAS. Many public water systems have their contact information on the water bill. You can also look up your public water system and how to contact them using your preferred internet browser. Private well owners are not required to test for PFAS, but you can test your water for PFAS using a private lab. To see a list of accredited labs that test water for PFAS, click on the lab link in the video description. What actions you need to take if your drinking water is above one or more of the SALs depends on whether you get your drinking water from a public water system or a private well. You may not need to do anything if your public water system is already taking action. Your water system will contact you to inform you about what actions they are taking if there are PFAS in your drinking water above a SAL. If you have a private well and have PFAS chemicals in your drinking water above one of the SALs, you can install a special water filter on your sink or a whole house filtration system that will remove PFAS. You can drink bottled water labeled purified if you can't install a filter. PFAS chemicals have been found in some bottled spring water. For long-term use, bottled water is not as regulated as tap water for many other contaminants. Bottled water also usually ends up costing more than installing and maintaining a filter. Compared to tap water, bottled water also has higher environmental impacts due to trucking bottled water to stores, making the plastic bottles, and disposing the bottles after use. There are two kinds of water filtration systems that you can install to lower PFAS levels in your drinking water. These systems are called whole house water filtration systems and point of use water filtration systems. Not all water filters work to lower PFAS levels in drinking water. Be sure to buy a water filter that is certified by a third party, like NSF, to lower PFAS. Water softeners do not lower PFAS levels in drinking water. Point of use water filtration systems attach to your sink or the tap you use for your drinking and cooking water. They are less expensive than whole house filtration systems and can be purchased online or at your local home improvement store. Not all point of use water filters work to lower PFAS levels. For more information on how to find a point of use filter that fits your needs, check out the link to our Home Water Treatment for PFAS guide in the video description. You can find a link to a list of filters certified to lower PFAS levels, the PFAS Point of Use Filter Options fact sheet, in the video description as well. Whole house water filtration systems treat all the water in your house for PFAS. They can be several thousand dollars to install. We recommend talking to a plumber with experience with PFAS filtering systems about your options if you are interested in installing a whole house water filtration system. If you are buying a whole house filtration system, make sure it is certified by a third party, like NSF, to reduce PFAS. PFAS in tap water don't get through the skin very well, so showering or bathing are not significant sources of PFAS exposure. Thanks for tuning into our PFAS Basics video series. In our next videos, we'll talk about other actions you can take to reduce your PFAS exposure and strategies to manage stress when you are impacted by environmental contaminants.
For more information, see our website at doh.wa.gov/PFAS.